beautiful voice, but there's somebody who has a more beautiful voice. الله يجزاك الخير.
شيخ
ما ما طلع؟ It's live now.
Is it live now?
Yeah, yeah, it's
live.
Yeah, it's live. إن الصفا والمروة. قبل الصفا ها؟ قبل الصفا. ولنبلونكم ولنبلونكم. شفتها؟ ولنبلونكم بشيء من الخوف والجوع ونقص من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات وبشر الصابرين. والعياذ بالله مش طالع شيء.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. ولنبلونكم بشيء من الخوف والجوع ونقص من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات وبشر الصابرين. الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون أولئك عليهم صلوات من ربهم ورحمة وأولئك هم المهتدون. إن الصفا والمروة من شعائر الله فمن حج البيت أو اعتمر فلا جناح عليه أن يطوف بهما ومن تطوع خيرا فإن الله شاكر عليم.
ما شاء الله، جزاك الله خير. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. بارك الله فيكم dear brothers and sisters. جزاكم الله خير. I ask Allah عز وجل to bless you and bless this gathering. ما في شيء أحلى وأعظم من كلام الله. There's nothing better than the words of Allah, and the words of Allah is the Quran. And here we are in this مجلس تعليم القرآن أو تفسير القرآن. إحنا نعم تعليم وتفسير القرآن. Talking about the book of Allah عز وجل. The most honorable ilm is ilm of the Quran. Why? Because هذا كلام الله. We stand and we pray and we recite without understanding what Allah says. When you give me that letter for me, so I can understand the message. So a lot of us are reading or listening to the Quran, but we don't understand the كلام الله. Quran كلام الله, and the Quran is basically do, don't, halal, haram, stories. Lessons from previous nations, future. This is what the Quran is all about. And then Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah Al-Baqarah. Yani this is Surah Al-Baqarah, and I promise you, inshallah ta'ala, we will not make it too long for you. Inshallah ta'ala, just short and sweet, bi-idhnillah. Surah Al-Baqarah, yani the longest surah in the Quran, surah azimah. It has, in fact, the longest ayah in the Quran, also in Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah Al-Dayn. Ayat al-Dayn, the ayah that talks about debts. Al-Dayn, we have in Arabic, we have al-Din and al-Dayn. Al-Din is religion. Al-Dayn is debts. يعني when I, you know, owe me something, I owe something. Al-Dayn, you know. So it has the longest ayah, which is towards the end. It's called Ayat al-Dayn. It's also in Surah Al-Baqarah. So we reach the ayah that talks about how Allah will afflict upon us. لَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ. And it, we talked about ابتلاء, and what is ابتلاء, and the meaning of ابتلاء from بلاء. بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ, with a touch of fear, with a touch of hunger, loss of property, loss of lives. وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ, and give glad tidings to the صابرين. الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. This is where we left off last week. إِنَّ لِلَّهُ وَإِنِّي رَاجِعُونَ. كلمة عظيمة. إِنَّ لِلَّهُ, to Allah we belong. This is the response to those who go through hardships. What do they say? إِنَّ لِلَّهُ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. كقول إبراهيم عليه السلام أو كقول يعقوب عليه السلام. يعقوب when he lost his son Yusuf, and then his other son, right, and the third one who stayed back in Egypt and did not want to come back to Palestine. قال إنما أشكو بثي وحزني إلى الله. This is لسان الحال إن لله وإني راجعون. إنما أشكو. This is what he says. You know that if I were to complain, I complain of my anguish and I complain of my sorrow to Allah. إن لله وإني راجعون. إنما أشكو بثي وحزني إلى الله. أيوب. أيوب he also said it, but in a different way. When Ayyub عليه السلام ربي مسني الضر وأنت أرحم الراحمين. والله I've been inflicted with evil with ضر وأنت أرحم الراحمين. إن لله وإني راجعون. You know, this is a very, very great, you know, dua to say or to repeat at times of calamity and hardships. إن لله وإنا إليه راجعون. لله ما أخذ وله ما أعطى. Allah Azza wa Jal is the supreme inheritor. Allah Azza wa Jal is a supreme inheritor. Al-Warith, Allah Jazak al-Khair. Al-Warith, Khairu al-Warithin. Al-Warith, he's the one who inherits everything, you know, eventually. So this is when we say, لِلَّهِ مَا أَخَدْ وَلَهُ مَا أَعْطَى. Allah is the one who gives, and Allah is the one who takes. He gives and he takes, subhanahu wa ta'ala. كَلِمَةٌ قَوِيَّةٌ وَعَظِيمَةٌ كَمَا قُلْنَّا. وَالْفَضَائِ الْمُتَرَتِّبَ عَلَيْهَا. إيش الْفَضَائِ الْمُتَرَتِّبَ عَلَيْهَا؟ When they said, إِنَّ لِلَهُنِ رَجِعُونَ, then associated with it comes a lot of goods. What are the goods? أُولَيْكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ وَأُولَيْكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ. أُولَيْكَ عَلَيْهِمْ, those upon them, salawat. In Arabic, there is salah, which is the one that we perform. And also there is another meaning of salah. خُذْ مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ يَا مُحَمَّدْ. خذ من أموالهم صدقة تطهرهم وتزكيهم بها وصل عليهم إن صلاتك سكن لهم. O Muhammad, take from them, from this, you know, from the people, from your companion, صدقة تطهرهم, صدقة, a charity. Why? To purify them, تطهرهم وتزكيهم بها, to raise their ranks in Jannah. وصل عليهم. صل إيش يعني, make salah upon them? No, صل عليهم means make dua for them. Is another meaning of salah is dua. So here when Allah says أولئك عليهم صلوات من ربهم, and also the plural of salah is salawat, not salah, salat or salawat. But here the meaning is different. It's not like the meaning Allah is praying استغفر on us. لا, صلوات من ربهم. And Allah did not only just mention salah. In English he just says blessings. خلاص, as simple, blessings. ورحمة. طيب, صلاة is رحمة, يعني دعاء. صلاة from the people is دعاء. From the angels, إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. So there is صلاة coming from the prophet to us and from the angels to us. It's what? It's دعاء to us. دعاء, the angels are making دعاء for us. This is what it means, صلاة, right? So here when Allah Azza wa Jalla says أُولَيْكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ, صلوات from Allah means رحمة from Allah. But here there's something different here, because Allah says صلوات and رحمة. But you already mentioned salah, why are you mentioning it again? I will answer the question inshaAllah ta'ala. فَلِمَنْ قَالَ إِنَّ لِلَّهُ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. To those who say إِنَّ لِلَّهُ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ, whenever they have been afflicted with musibah. And you know, musibah is a trial, is a hardship, is a calamity. And a calamity is not only when somebody dies. A lot of people, when they talk about musibah, like, oh, somebody dies is musibah. No, definitely. But musibah to salah is the one who does not pray. Isn't that a musibah? He doesn't pray. Isn't that a musibah? If your son does not pray, isn't that a musibah? Your spouse does not pray. Isn't that a musibah? The one who does not fast. Isn't that a musibah? Al-musibah fi al-din akhtar wa a'zam. Didn't the Prophet used to make this dua? Allahumma la ta'al musibatana fi deenina. Wa Allah, don't make our musibah in our deen. Because the musibah in the deen is the greatest musibah. Allah takes an eye, you have another one to see with. Allah takes both, alhamdulillah, there is nothing, I don't want to see anything any more haram, khalas, they are in Jannah waiting for me. Allah takes one hand, he gives you another. Allah takes one son, he gives another. Allah, and so on and so forth. You know, but al-musibah fi al-deen, You know, you're the Muslim, may Allah forbid, and then tomorrow you become kafir. That's the worst musibah. He prays today and tomorrow he quits praying. That's the worst musibah. Al-musibah fi al-deen. And also, there's one nuqta I'd like to point to. Nuqta muhimma jiddan. أن في كل شيء خير. الذين إذا قالوا إن لله وإنا راجعون. الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا إن لله وإنا راجعون. أولئك عليهم صلوات من ربهم ورحمة وأولئك هم المهتدون. So everything that happens to you and I, to any human being, there is خير in it. Doesn't Allah سبحانه وتعالى says, قل اللهم مالك الملك من سورة آل عمران. قل اللهم مالك الملك تؤتي الملك من تشاء. الملك تؤتي الملك. You give sovereignty to whomever you wish. Isn't that خير? Allah gives dominion and sovereignty, mulk, to whoever He wishes. So that's خير. And He removes it from whoever He wishes. There's also خير in it. تؤتي الملك من تشاء وتنزع الملك ممن تشاء وتعز من تشاء وتذل من تشاء بيدك الخير. بيدك الخير. You give honor to whomever you wish and you disgrace whomever you wish. بيدك الخير. The khair is in your hand, subhanak. The khair is in your hand. So whatever happens to you and I or to any of your friends or to anybody, be it the Muslims in Gaza or the Muslims in Lebanon or in Afghanistan or in Kashmir or in Al-Yemen or in Al-Sudan, khair. Inshallah khair. يعني it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كله خير. ولكن الشر كمان بيده الله سبحانه وتعالى. الخير بيد الله. And شر, شر means evil, the opposite of خير, is also under the hands of Allah. ولكن للأدب مع الله, للأدب مع الله سبحانه وتعالى, لا ننسب له إلا الخير. Because with the etiquettes, أدب with Allah عز وجل, so we only attribute to Him only that which is good. الخير is from Allah. And evil is from him too, subhanahu wa ta'ala. But with adab of Allah, we only attribute that which is good to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And some people say, الشر من الشيطان, Allah Azza wa Jal, from Allah Azza wa Jal, subhanahu wa ta'ala. قالوا إن لله وإن إليه راجعون. And this, those who say إن لله, as if this musiba is to them and to whatever happens unto all the entire nation, all over the world. يعني the Muslims who are going through musibah, they are in Palestine, let's say, in Palestine. You and I are here in Canada. And then when we hear somebody from Palestine got killed, what do we say? إِنَّ لِلَّهُ نَرْجِعُونَ. As if the musibah happened to us. The musibah that happens in Sham. It's not to me, but it happened there in Sham or in Lebanon. You and I were here. So what do we say? We say, إِنَّ لِعَزِبْ. It happened to us. This is the beauty. When the Prophet says, when just like a body, when one organ goes through pain, the entire body feels the pain. This is how we deal with musibah. It doesn't have to happen to me for me to say, إِنَّ لِلَّهُ وَإِنَّ رَاجِعُونَ. It could happen to any Muslim, anywhere in the world, and you and I will say, إِنَّ لِلَّهُ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. As if the musibah happened to us. This is the meaning of, you know, the beauty of the meaning of this ayah. أُولَئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ وَأُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. Look, as I said, as if the musibah is to musibah. The musibah of losing someone, and the musibah of the family. The one who died, خلاص, it's musibah. He's already dead, miskeen. So he says, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ. He goes to Allah. And who goes, وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ? You and I, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ, وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. To him we shall come back, subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why the Prophet Muhammad, whenever, إِذَا مَرَّ مِنْ قَبْرٍ مَاذَا كَانَ دُعَاؤُهُ. إِذَا مَرَّ مِنْ قَبْرٍ, السلام عليكم أهل قوم المؤمنين. أنتم السابقون نحن اللاحقون نحن الله لنا بكم ولنا ولكم العافية. He used to say السلام عليكم دار أقل قوم المؤمنين, to the people, the believers from the grave. He would make salam to them. You are the سابقون, you went in first, and we shall join you. We shall be coming and joining. نعم, we shall be coming يعني. نسأل الله لنا ولكم العافية. أولئك أولئك أيها العرب، هل أولئك إشارة للقريب أم من البعيد؟ أولئك it's a sign, it's like يعني you point towards something near or something far. Allah Azza wa Jalla says those who are afflicted by the مصيبة they say إِنَّ لِلَهُ نِرَجْعُونَ. And then Allah says أُولَئِكَ لَهُمْ أُولَئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ أُولَئِكَ يعني is أُولَئِكَ points to something far or something near. When you say أُولَئِكَ is something far. أُولَئِكَ للبعيد ما هو للقريب، للقريب هؤلاء هؤلاء أنتم أنتم هؤلاء بس أولئك هذاك اللي واقف هناك اللي برا أولئك اللي بعيد أولئك. الله عز وجل is mentioning أولئك for these people. Why؟ هناك هنا لأهل الصبر. ليش أولئك؟ بعد في المنزلة، منزلتهم عالية أهل الصبر. Is that the people who are going through this calamity and then they show impatience. Why أولئك؟ This is why, because of their higher rank, high, far rank in the day of judgment. So Allah says, أولئك لهم صلوات عند ربهم، صلوات عند ربهم ورحمة. كم من صلاة؟ صلوات. How many صلاة؟ We don't know. It's infinite. صلوات من ربهم. From their Lord. How many? One, two, how many? صلوات من ربهم. You can't count. Those patients, they will have صلوات من ربهم. Endless صلوات from their Lord. And when we talk about صلوات here, we talk about blessings from their Lord. You cannot enumerate it. It's something that is unlimited. صلوات من ربهم. ورحمة. وقلنا الصلاة هي الرحمة. We just said that salah is rahmah. But Allah Azza wa Jalla is making a distinction between these two here. And also Allah Azza wa Jalla, He did not use salawatun min rabbihim. He didn't say salawatun min Allahi wa rahmah. Remember the difference between al-Rabb and Allah? Ism Allah al-Jalala. This is why the du'as in the Quran, this is why the du'a, most of the du'a in the Quran, Rabbana, Rabbana, atina fi al-dunya hasan fi al-akhirati hasan qina adab al-nar. Rabbana, inna sami'na munadin yunadi bil-iman, amin, Rabbana, Rabbana. So this Rabbana is, this is why the Prophet Muhammad in his du'a, he used to combine with Allahumma Rabbana. Allah, Ism al-Jalala, with Rabb, the Master. سبحانه وتعالى. This is why Allah عز وجل says here, أولئك عليهم صلوات من ربهم. Closer. Allah is, but رب is closer. ورحمة. يا أيها الناس اعبدوا ربكم الذي خلقكم والذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. اعبدوا ربكم. So there's a distinction between الرب and Allah. And الإله. And الواحد. And الأحد. You may look at it and say, it's all the same. No, they're not the same. Al-Rab is Al-Rab. In Arabic, we say Rabbul Bayt. The master of the house. Al-Rab, Rabbul Bayt. But this dua has Tawheed al-Uluhiyya and Tawheed al-Rububiyya. Both. The oneness of the Rububiyya, Rabb. Rabb is the master, is the creator. Al-Ilah is different. Quraysh, what did they have? They had Rabb, they had Tawheed Rububiyya, they didn't have Tawheed Uluhiyya. What's the difference between Rububiyya and Uluhiyya? Uluhiyya is that your worship is only to Allah, nothing else. When you worship, you only worship Allah. But Rububiyya, Rabb is different. وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَةَ الْأَرْضِ يَقُولُنَّ Allah. If you were to ask them who created the heavens and the earth, they will say, Allah. They believe that Allah is the creator. But whenever they need to ask something, they would not ask Him directly. They will ask the gods. They will ask the idols. So there's a difference between, of course, Al-Rabb and Al-Ilah and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So here, for closeness, أُولَيْكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ الصَّلَاةُ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرَحْمَةٌ وَمِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ دُعَاءٌ. الصَّلَاةُ from Allah to us is rahmah, is blessings. And from the angels is dua from the angels. Rahmah from Allah and dua from the people. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. I just mentioned this ayah. إن الله وملائكته, Allah and His angels, they make salah upon the Prophet. What does that mean? Salah upon the Prophet, يعني رحم, you know, رحمة towards the Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام. وكأن الله سبحانه يقول أولئك عليهم صلوات أو رحمات من ربهم ورحمة. أولئك عليهم رحمات ورحمة. As if Allah is saying those upon them too many رحمات and رحمات. But what's the difference here? رحمة متعددة في الدنيا ورحمة خاصة في الآخرة. الله أكبر. رحمات متعددة, صلوات, lots of رحمة in this dunya. Then the Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام says that Allah عز وجل has 100 رحمة, 99 are being stored and saved in the Day of Judgment, and only one rahmah of Allah has been used here amongst all mankind and all animals and all beings. Imagine Allah created one rahmah. This is why His name is Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, by the way. He created one rahmah. Allah Azza wa Jalla khalaqa 100 rahmah. We're using only one rahmah amongst you. Rahmah that you used with Adam and with Yusuf, and rahmah that you use for your son, and rahmah that I use my son, and that brother who's dead, rahmah that you use with your son, is only one rahmah. The rahmah that a mother uses with her baby, the rahmah that you use with your parents, and the parents used to work. This, all of us are surviving, even the animals. A dog with a puppy, a cat with a kitten. They're only using only one rahmah of Allah, and 99 rahmah to be stored, to be used in the Day of Judgment. Yalla, udkhul al-jannah, udkhul al-jannah. Rahman, ghafoor, maghfoor, 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 maghfoor. Rahmah of Allah Azza wa Jal. He loves to be merciful, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, why again salawat, rahmat? As if Allah is telling you and I, too many rahmat here, and one major rahmah in the Day of Judgment, to forgive you and make you admitted to Jannah. Ulaika alayhim salawatun rabbihim wa rahmah. As if Allah Azza wa Jalla, when He says, "Man kana aduwan lillahi wa malaikatihi," also in Surah Al-Baqarah, "Man kana aduwan lillahi wa malaikatihi wa Jibreel wa Mikael." We just mentioned the malaika. Why did you mention Jibreel and Mikael, you know, distinctly, like, you know, other than the malaika? Why do we do this in Arabic? تفضيل. A more emphasis. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, "Man kana, whoever is an enemy of Allah and His angels and Jibreel and Mikael." Isn't Jibreel before you go to sleep, huh? Is Jibreel and Mikael, they are angels? They are, huh? I'm just asking, are they angels? Well, yes or yes? Okay, so Allah says, those who are enemy of Allah and the angels and Jibreel and Mikael. You just said angels, ya Allah. Why do you have to repeat it again? You just said it. Tafdeel. And oh yeah, there's a more importance here about these two particular angels, right? There's a distinction here, distinction for these two particular angels. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ الْمُهْتَدُونَ. And indeed those, not only they will get the rahmah from Allah, rahmah from the angels, you know, the blessings and the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ. And those, they will be truly guided, hidayah. And what's the best ni'mah, brothers? Okay, tell me. What is the greatest ni'mah that Allah bless a person with? A person with? Hidayah. Islam, but hidayah to Islam. You prayed Isha with us and you chose to stay. And I always say this, giving the benefit of the doubt to those who didn't stay. Let's give them the benefit of the doubt. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala selected you meticulously to stay for this few minutes. To gain the ajr, to gain the rahmah of the angels who are here. Rahmah of Allah Azza wa Jalla who's standing it down, as the Prophet Muhammad alayhi wa sallam, when he says, مَجْتَمْعَ قَوْمٌ فِي بَيْتٍ بِبِيُوتِ اللَّهِ يَتَدَرَّسُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ أَوْ يَتَدَرَّسُونَهُ إِلَّا وَنَزَلَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ الرَّحْمَةُ وَغَشَتْهُمُ السَّكِينَةُ وَذَكَّرَهُمُ اللَّهِ فِي مَنْ عِنْدَهُ. So Allah Azza wa Jal meticulously selected to be here so that you can receive these overwhelming rahmah that descend from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and sakina and tranquility from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the best, so Allah guided you to be here. And remember about the guidance. There's a guidance which you can give, and there's a guidance which you cannot give. Even Prophet Muhammad, could Prophet Muhammad guide his uncle, Abu Talib? إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتُ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهِ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. You cannot give guidance to whomever you wish. But Allah is the one who guides whomever who wishes, subhanahu wa ta'ala. But there's another ayah that says, إِنَّكَ لَتَهْدِي إِلَىٰ صِرَاطِ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. You surely can guide people to the straight path. What's the difference? You can guide me to tell me the straight path. You can show it to me. You can show me directions. Like the brother who went to the Indian, I think, or Pakistani, who got lost in Mina. He got lost in Mina and he did not know there was too many towns, there were too many people. He has his ID with his address on his ID, he's got his address also. He found a policeman, you know, an officer. He says, officer, ya shorti, ihdina sirat al-mustaqim. Ihdina sirat, yani, show me the address, show me, guide me to my home, guide me to my tent. Ihdina sirat al-mustaqim. Although the sirat is only any sirat. So you cannot give yet. You cannot give hidayah yet. You can give hidayah. You can show the directions. You can tell people that what you're doing is haram. What's halal? This is halal. Coming to the masjid is good. Staying in this type of gatherings is good. Staying away from that is bad. Staying away from that is now. These are the things that you can guide people towards. But the hidayah to Jannah, the hidayah to Islam. The only who can give is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَنْ يَهْدِي اللَّهُ فَهُوَ الْمُهْتَدِ إِنَّكَ لَنْ تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتِ. So here, in few more minutes, why this ayah? And after this ayah, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, إِنَّ الصَّفَا وَالْمَرْوَةَ مِنْ شَعَائِلِ اللَّهِ. Right after talking about ibtila. And right after talking about what would people who persevere and endure through these types of hardship, what would they get? Allah Azza wa Jalla says, "Inna al-Safa wal-Marwa min shahaidillah." Al-Safa wal-Marwa. The Prophet Muhammad, whenever he used to finish his tawaf, you know, when he's doing Umrah, right, or Hajj, you finish your tawaf. The Sunnah is you go to Zamzam, you drink Zamzam. Or before drinking Zamzam, you pray to Raka'ah, as Sunnah. If you don't pray this to Raka'ah, by the way, just so you know, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going in December, huh? December, this coming December, I'm going for Umrah, inshallah ta'ala. As it is, every December, we go for Umrah, inshallah ta'ala. So if you want to go, let me know, inshallah ta'ala, huh? It's Christmas Umrah, right? It's a New Year's Umrah. It's the busiest Umrah in the whole year, right? It's like Hajj. It's really busy. When you do Umrah, when you do Tawaf, right? After Tawaf, there's a sunnah that the Prophet would pray to Raka'ah behind the station of Ibrahim, if you can. Some people say, I did not pray to Raka'ah, my Umrah is spoiled, this Quran. It's not accepted. No, this is just a sunnah. It's good to do it. If you don't do it, it's okay. But then, what happened? When you go towards As-Safa, the Mount of As-Safa, the Prophet recited this ayah. إِنَّ الصَّفَا وَالْمَرْوَةَ مِنْ شَعَائِلِ اللَّهِ فَمَنْ حَجَّ الْبَيْتَ وَاعْتَمَرَ فَلَا جُنَاحَ عَلَيْهِ أَنْ يَطَّوَّفَ بِهِمَا وَمَنْ تَطَوَّعَ خَيْرًا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ شَاكِرٌ عَلِيمٌ. Why? After that, Allah talks about this. This masa'ib that we talked about, the musibat of a Jew, the musibah of al-khawf, the musibah of hunger, the musibah of famine, of fear, the musibah of loss of lives, the musibah of loss of crops or properties. This lady, Hajar, had to go through all this by herself. And we will go through it one by one. This musibah that we talked about, she went through them all. By herself, هاجر ابتليت بنقص من الأموال وحدها ما عندها مال الأنفس إبراهيم تركها وراح إبراهيم he left her and he left in the midst of nowhere الخوف fear by herself with her baby where? In the middle of the desert even you by yourself even يا معلم Even you, mashallah, with all your muscles and everything, you lost by yourself in the desert. Wouldn't you be afraid? Wouldn't you be terrified? Wouldn't you be scared? Let alone a woman by herself, or baby crying, and there are bandits at the time, everywhere. She's miskina, of course. Shay'in min al-khawf. Of course she's scared and terrified. Jour. جوع means hunger. Wasn't she hungry? Why Ismail was crying? Why do baby cries? Babies, what do they cry?
I think because of...
Why baby cries? Oh, because they need milk. That means they're hungry. صح. Because they need milk. Because they, or you want to change their diaper also. Check their diaper, huh? Just let your mom, you know. Tell mom, mom, I know now. I know when I used to cry when I was a baby. You used to feed me, but I wanted to change my diaper. My diaper. Or, I mean, okay, I'm just, no. But it is the food. Normally they're hungry. Or maybe they're sick. They have a stomachache or something. They go to some place. They cry. So here, Ismail, alayhi salam, in the desert, he's crying. And came, and then she was saying, zim, 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 zim. In one narration, zim, 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 yani, be quiet. In another narration, zim, 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 yani, when the Jibril came and sprang and hit the ground with his wing, sprang out zim, zim, and then she went, you know, collecting the, you know, she did not want to let the water to spread all over the Arab Peninsula. Where Muhammad says, Rahimallahu Ismail, may Allah have mercy on the mother of Ismail. Had she let the water flow, the zim, zim would have flown everywhere in جزيرة العرب. يعني لبنان, you will be drinking زمزم. In Syria, you will be drinking زمزم. In Palestine, you will be drinking زمزم. In Al-Urdun, you will be drinking زمزم. But أمنا هاجر, she collected the water. No, she didn't want the water to flow everywhere. She collected زمزم, زم. No, don't go زمزم هنا. زمزم, زمزم. She went through all this مصائب. فنزل جبريل عليه السلام. وتفجر العين أو تفجرت أو تفجر اللبن في صدرها. So when she drank زمزم milk, because her breast dried out, she had no more milk to feed her baby, to breastfeed her baby. So when she drank زمزم, one صحابي كان أحد من الصحابة مكث في مكة في الحرم 40 يوم. أبو ذر الغفاري اللي هو 40 يوم. أبو ذر لما طلع من هذا روى عليه يعني شيء من السمن. He gained weight. He remained in the haram for like 30 days drinking زمزم only. When he came out, they told him, you gained some weight. زمزم. Only زمزم. The water. That food, it's got everything. This is why this water is from Jannah. When these Germans, they came to do their research of the source of زمزم, they couldn't find no source. So this man, this Japanese guy, he wrote a book, ما يتكلم. He wrote a book, Talking Water. He did his research. He's a scientist, a German scientist, brought some water and then some other water, and then he did some research. He says, this water right here, he says, there's something in it. It moves, it talk, as if the water talks. There's a book. So when they got to Zamzam, she drank Zamzam, and then her breast, subhanAllah, I wouldn't say manufactured. now she got, you know, she got milk, and then she breastfed her baby Ismail alayhi salam. Then Allah says, Inna Safa wal Marwata min sha'a'ilillah. What was Hajar doing when Ibrahim left her? She was going between. She may have said, Ibrahim, you're my husband. And you are a prophet, okay? And I'm sure you made dua for me, and Allah Azza wa Jalla told you to leave us here, so I'm going to sit here and wait for a miracle to happen. She didn't say that. And she didn't do that, did she? No. What did she do? She said, walking between As-Safa and Marwa, walking between the two mounts. What we call today As-Sa'i. As-Sa'i. And this is a message of rizq. You have to work on it. You have to strive towards it. Rizq. Sustenance. Sustenance doesn't come to you. You have to work for it. In Surah Al-Mulk, what does Allah Azza wa Jalla says? الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا وَتَلْآيَمْ بَعْدِينَ تبارك الذي بيده الملك وعلى كل شيء قدير الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم حسن ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا وهو الغزيز الغفور الذي خلق سبع سماوات طباقا ما ترى في خلق الرحمن من تفاوت فارجع البصر ترى من فضل ثم ارجع البصر كرتين ينقلب إليك البصر خاسما وحسيرا ولقد زينا السماء الدنيا بمصابيح وجعلناها رجوما للشياطين وأعددنا لهم عذاب السعير وللذين كفروا عذاب جهنم وبئس المصير إذا ألقوا فيها سمعوا لها شهيقا وهي تفور تكاد تميز من الغيظ كلما سألهم خلاص ألم يأتكم نذير قالوا بلى قد جاءنا نذير فكذبنا وقلنا ما نزل الله من شيء إن أنتم إلا في ضلال كبير وقالوا لو كنا نسمع ونعقل ما كنا في أصحاب السعير فاعترفوا بذنب فسحقا لأصحاب السعير إن الذين يخشون ربهم بالغيب لهم مغفرة وأجر كبير وأسروا قولكم أو اجهروا به إنه عليم بذات الصدور ألا يعلم من خلق وهو اللطيف الخبير هو الذي هذه هي هو الذي جعل لكم الأرض ذلولا فامشوا في مناكبها وكلوا من رزقه وإليه النشور That's the eye I was looking for فامشوا في مناكبها Walk on earth Keep working وكلوا من رزقه And eat from the assistance of Allah Allah didn't say sit and wait for the assistance to come to you لا فسعوا في مناكبها اسع اسع في الأرض So here, اسعوا اسعوا What did she do between الصفا والمروة? السعي Between الصفا والمروة وكل من رزقه وإليه النشور So those of you who are going through any مصيبة It could be you and I We're going through some sort of hardship Whatever the hardship is تذكر أمك هاجر Remember هاجر عليه السلام And what she had to go through أولئك كان جزاؤها What's her reward from Allah عز وجل صلوات من ربها ورحمة We go back to صلوات من ربها ورحمة وأولئك هم المهتدون So this is why And I will add inshallah When we make the تحيات لله At the end الصلوات إبراهيمية Or the درود اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم آل إبراهيم The family of إبراهيم يعقوب إسحاق His wife يوسف إسماعيل From the you know the fruit of the sabr of Hajar عليها السلام نعم 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 إن الصفا والمروة من شعائر الله indeed the hills of الصفا and المروة and among the symbols or the rituals of Allah so whoever makes حج or عمرة let them walk between them اختلف العلماء 1 minute 30 seconds The ulama, they اختلفوا في السبب نزول هذه الآية على ثلاث أقوال. There is this discrepancy among the scholars with regard to why this ayah was revealed. Right? Why this ayah was revealed. There are three opinions. One opinion that says, As-Safa wal-Marwa, there were two, there was a couple, a man and a woman, الرجل إساف and the مرأة نائلة نائلة is a woman and a man they entered the كعبة and they committed حرام in it inside so Allah سبحانه وتعالى cursed them into two idols so Quraysh what did they do they put the man صفا والومن مروة ولا مروة صفا والمروة in response to what happened to them as they were still Quraysh they were not believers indication to anyone who tried to commit some sort of wrong inside the haram as they also believe in the haram this is what will happen to them Allah will curse them and turn them into you know into rocks into stones so this is the into the you know the ayah as-safa is there was one idol into the Safa and then there was one idol into Marwa so the Sahaba when Islam came because I didn't give you the explanation when Islam came and the Sahaba who were before they were you know from Mushrikeen a lot of them were Mushrikeen so they oh remember we used to make a Safa or Marwa but in the when we were because the Mushrikeen also Quraysh they used to do Tawaf they used to do Hajj They used to do tawaf, and after tawaf, they would go and do safa or marwa. They used to do these rituals, but in a different way. So some of them, oh, there's marwa there. There's a, now that we're Muslims, then we should not be doing tawaf between sa'i, between safa or marwa, because there are idols there. They said, oh, Rasulullah, we used to do this, but there's one idol here and one idol there. We should do safa or marwa. Prophet Muhammad, he used to do tawaf. Do you know when he did his hajj? Just only a few months before he died, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Sana Ashira, right? And then Umrah, I will tell you how many umrahs he did, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first umrah on the 7th of the Hijrah, when he did his umrah, he made tawaf. He made tawaf. What was inside the Kaaba at the time? Idols. Idols. They were idols. So the Prophet did tawaf around the Kaaba, but he did not do Hajj. And one of the secrets as maybe why the Prophet did not do Hajj until after Islam spread and he conquered Mecca, because he cleaned the Kaaba from all the asnaf, from all the idols. So he did, but he did Umrah before while there was. And he did the Safa wal Marwa while there was two idols, As-Safa wal Marwa. So this came the ayah that says, إِنَّ الصَّفَ وَالْمَرْضَ مِنْ شَعَيْرِ اللَّهِ فَمَنْ حَجَّ الْبَيْتِ وَاعْتَمْرَ فَلَا جُنَاحَ عَلَيْهِ فَلَا جُنَاحَ عَلَيْهِ. This is one opinion, one يعني statement. There's another two statements. What are they? And what is the meaning of لَا جُنَاحَ عَلَيْهِمَا? And what is the best time to do Umrah? What's the best time to do Umrah, by the way? I know you're going to say Ramadan. Wrong.
Hey,
what wrong?
Say Christmas.
Christmas, because we said Ramadan and you said Ramadan because all of you think of the hadith that Rasulullah says, you know, Umrah fi Ramadan ka hajjatan ma'i. You know, the Umrah in Ramadan as if you're doing Hajj with me. So a lot of people say Ramadan. La. The best Umrah of all time. Next time, inshallah ta'ala, we will talk about this. Not next week. Next, we will talk about it. Unfortunately, not next Thursday because I will not be here. But the following Thursday, inshallah, we'll be back. So next Thursday, there will be no lecture. But the following Thursday, inshallah, we'll talk about